As soon as you insult my family, all bets are off.
Right now on South Beach Show.
It sounds like there's a dog in here.
Oh, man.
You are not.
You're not listening. That's my dog.
Getting the dog back.
Get my dog. Take my dog.
You don't want a baby girl?
Go ahead, Dad.
Make sure you got that gate ready.
Here they come. Here they come.
Hey, yo, pull the car over.
Close that gate.
And then close.
Money,
got it, got it.
Taxi in the loading zone, en route.
I'm gonna get my bag.
He's gonna leave and he's not gonna...
This car now, get my bag.
You gotta realize, this is Miami. This is the heat. You feel what I'm saying? This 100-something degrees outside. It ain't up north, we on the bottom of the map.
Tremont.
Hey, this is John from the B&B. I got one of these 30-minute meters up front, and somebody's been there for like 2 hours. I gotta get out of here.
All right, honey, not a problem. What kind of car is it?
It's a black SUV, a Mercedes black SUV. I need to get out of here.
You got it, honey. I'll send them right over, okay?
All right, thank you so much.
You're welcome, sweetie. Jimani.
All right, baby, let me go make this money.
Bring me a bag of milkshakes.
It's hot as hell out here. I'm getting in and out of here fast. Get me a cold drink. There you go. That's my little female right there.
About that time to hook and pull. She slip, I grip.
When was this car brought in?
Last night, like at 2 in the morning.
Was it
Jerome?
A what?
Jerome, come here.
What's up, baby? You straight?
It sounds like there's a dog in here.
You lying.
Dog? Well, I ain't hear no dog in no car.
It's like 100 degrees outside. If there's a dog in there, it's gonna die.
Man, it feel like an oven in here. Oh, man, look here.
Are you kidding me?
No, I'm serious.
There's a freaking Pomeranian in a freaking bag in a freaking car, and it's 100 and something degrees in the car.
They tripping.
Is he okay?
Tag on the name Muffin. I guess her name is Muffin. I say, this dog hydrated. We need to get some water or something for the dog. So I went over here, cleaned out the cigarette pan, got a nice little bottle of water, put some water in the pan, fed the dog some water.
It's like 100 degrees outside, no food, no water. That poor little thing could die. If we ever find any animal in any vehicle, we call animal rescue. Not because we have to, but because we're animal lovers. How are you gonna spend this much money on this dog and that collar and then just like discard it? This is not an accessory, it's an actual living thing.
Animal lady showed up. I said, God, who is that?
Baby.
Okay.
She gorgeous.
Can I see the dog, please? Let me see it under.
Hey, doggy, how you doing?
I just wanted to be clear, so when she comes to get her car, she knows this dog absolutely cannot go back to her.
And she's driving a Mercedes, so she could have got a dog sitter for the dog instead of leaving it in the damn car. I hate this. I get these calls all the time, and the people, I don't know.
The way she was talking, she sounded real sexy. Got a man you married?
Sir, I'm really trying to take care of this right now.
Can you hold? All you gotta say is a yes or no. You married?
Yes, no. Sir, please, you're really confusing me.
Where your boyfriend at? You treat your boyfriend like that?
I don't bring my boyfriend to work, sir. I'm sorry.
You ain't gotta bring your boyfriend to work.
Well, I'm talking about the dog, sir. I'm talking about the dog.
We can go on a date three. We can make it a triple date if you want to.
Okay.
I'm down with you.
Okay, okay.
How can I help you, ma'am?
Okay.
You towing my car?
Okay, what kind of car?
I have a black Mercedes SUV.
A black
I need
SUV.
My car back. I really don't appreciate this.
Are you aware that you left your dog in the car?
Yeah, I know my dog was in the car.
Hi, ma'am, excuse me, hello. I am with Animal Rescue Services. You left your dog in the car, in a hot car. It's illegal to leave an animal in the car with the windows rolled up per Florida Statute 828073, ma'am. I have the authority to remove the dog from your custody, ma'am, okay? Which means you are not taking the dog home today, okay? Do you understand that?
So what you're saying is...
What I'm saying is what I've
already
said.
You took my car, you took my dog. My dog, especially bred, it cost over $3,000.
Okay, ma'am, listen to me.
That's grand theft.
If you would like to make an appointment with my agency, you could do that, ma'am. That's fine.
I'm not having a conversation with you.
Can you hear me?
Now listen to me.
That means she hear me. That means you are not...
You're not listening. That's my dog.
Getting the dog back.
Thank God that glass is there, because these women were going to claw each other's eyes out.
You're so in my face, I want...
Put on my back.
get in your face because you're around the corner and okay, then
I couldn't handle anymore. So I'm like, all right, you know what? You just like sit down and take care of the muffin. And you go to the gate, I'm gonna deal with you there. So ma'am, we can get your car out today, but you're really gonna have to take it up with her and her bosses.
This really ruined my day. You don't understand. You're really not giving me my dog back?
Ma'am, they've made the choice.
That's my dog.
Then you can take it up with them when you book the meeting with her and her superiors.
I'm gonna cry, like that's terrible. I can't believe you're doing that.
Ma'am, it's not me.
Can I at least come in and see my dog? Can I at least say goodbye to him? Seriously. How much do I owe you?
It's $210 to get the car.
Let me just say goodbye to Muffin.
I'll ask them.
Please.
And I'll see what they say.
I promise that I'll behave. I promise.
I'll ask them. Is anybody opposed to Muffin's mommy coming in and saying goodbye?
2 minutes. If you're taking my dog and you're really keeping my dog,
okay,
I need to say goodbye.
Bunny, come say goodbye. So I'm like, fine. You can come inside. You can see your Muffin. You can apologize to the lady. And you can go.
Muffin.
And then she tries to take her dog back.
Give me my dog.
I like when all the women will fight around me because I feel like they were trying to fight over me.
What you gonna do? You're not getting the dog.
Come on.
I don't care how much you
have. That's okay.
No, you're right.
Okay.
You're right about that. That's the only reason I'm gonna back up off her ass because I'm about to lay her out.
Sorry. Muffin, don't worry. This isn't gonna get you. That's my dog.
After the angry old lady left, I still went back inside and threw my little sweet Mac game at her. Says I.
I'm saying, calm down.
You know what I'm saying? Let me just take you out and release your stress. That's it. You feel what I'm saying? You
like that? My stress release.
Huh? You might go ahead and write your number down on this piece of paper right here. And still got them 7 digits.
Say bye, no. You wanna say bye?
Yeah, let me get it to you. Bye, baby. I'll give you a call soon, man, for that date. Man, I'm gonna rock that world. Watch.
Big P ain't paid his bills, player. We're taking the car.
You need to listen.
I did.
Don't make me hurt you.
South Beach at Night brings every crazy person out on the streets. You get it all on South Beach.
It's a full moon, and that means we got the crazies out.
Just like any other night.
Yeah, it's just like every other night. That's what you keep on saying.
Superstition.
Yeah, superstition. Yeah, my superstition keeps us alive.
Tonight is the first time I'm taking my son on a night repo. We do repos at night because everybody's gonna be asleep, less confrontations. We're going out to look for this Chrysler 300 two-tone. I skip-traced it. I found an area where it seems to be many times during the week.
Let's keep our eyes open. It's two-tone Chrysler tricked out, so it should be rather easy to spot. So
that's a wide open area, too.
Should be an easy pick. Keep your eyes open. Chrysler two-tone tricked out.
We try to stay under the radar. We don't want nobody noticing that we're actually looking for something.
Oh, look at that. What's that on the left here? All the way in the front.
There it is. We spot it. Can't miss this car. It was nothing but Gucci everywhere you saw it.
All right. You got it? You got it hooked.
All right. Daytime, you can see everything. You can see all your surroundings. But at nighttime, you can't see nothing.
Yo, 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 hold up. Yo, that's my dog, Big Peace, bro. What's going on, yo? What's this?
What's the deal? Hey, yo, big man, what's
going on? Yo, bud, I got a work order for this. A guy named Percy. Percy called me. He wants to get it to a repair shop, so I'm taking it to a repair shop.
It's my man's car. He's working on his album right now.
Is his name Percy?
Nah, it's Big P, yo. It's the next big thing.
Well, Big P, his name is actually Percy, and we're taking his car to a repair shop. He said he had a problem with it. We're taking it to the repair shop.
these guys just weren't biting, man, you know, and he kept on and kept on.
I got a work order for you, really.
Work order.
My man's in the studio right now.
Finally, I just got tired of it. Your boy's a deadbeat, bro. Right, he owes on this car, bro, 6 months.
You.
My son decides that he wants to do it what he calls the modern way. Get in your face, tell you, I'm taking...
Oh, Big P ain't paid his bills, Blair. We're taking the car.
It's Big P's car, man. You can't take the car like that, Big.
Once you start telling people that you're actually repoing the car, it's going to escalate.
I don't know who this guy Big P is, but I mean, he must have been paying these guys some pretty good money.
Drop the car.
Bud,
drop the car.
Back off.
Yo, drop the car.
Bye, guys.
Yo,
hey, yo. Go.
Yo, drop the car, yo.
We can't let him get away with the car. Let's go.
What the is that?
I'm telling him to repair work, and you're telling him repo?
Hey, yo, what's the deal? Hey, yo, pull the car.
What's wrong with you? You need to listen.
I did.
No, you didn't listen. You didn't follow cue. Enough of this. What are you this here for? Next to us, running some residential areas. You need this?
Here they come. Here they come.
Hey, yo, pull the car over. Hey, yo, pull the car over.
Unit one, the baby girl.
Go ahead, Dan.
We're heading there real hot. They're on my six. Make sure you got that gate ready. I need to get in there. You need to close it right behind me.
All right, I'm hitting the gate right now.
We're coming up.
Go, I open the gate.
Go.
They pull in.
Go, let's go, let's go.
These people that are chasing them are literally less than a foot away from them. They are riding on their ass.
Close that gate, close that gate, close that gate.
Oh, no, it didn't close.
Okay, we're gonna have to deal with it in here too. Once these guys follow us into the yard, it's now a matter of protection. They could have a knife, they could have a gun, they could have bats in the car. You have to be really on your guard.
I do not realize it right now, man. You understand? This owns this city right now. And you don't own that's Big P's ride.
That's my ride now.
Wait, right now. Big P's on the way. I'll take this car my damn self. Take this car my damn self.
You better not.
Then the one idiot decides he's jumping into my truck. Nobody jumps in my truck.
Yo, hold on. Yo.
If you're gonna disturb our peace, we're gonna shatter yours.
Don't make me hurt you, man.
So we got them under control. They're not gonna get away with the car.
This is some you're gonna see what time it is.
After this wonderful exercise unit I just had, now my anger is aiming towards my son.
You don't get it, do you?
It wasn't working over there, man. It wasn't
but
how
working. How many repos you done? Done 2 repos. I done 1,000. You don't know what works.
This might have not have been the smoothest repo ever, but my dad is blowing this way out of proportion. We got the car. That's all that really matters.
You need to shut up and listen. That's what you need to do. Or find another career.
Yo, we back, man.
Yo, we back, man.
We're back for that car.
I want to see what Big P looks like. This must be a monster.
We back, man.
We back for that car.
Oh, I got him. Hi, how you doing, sweetheart?
Hi.
I heard there was a situation going on with my friends and my vehicle and everything.
Your friends, your vehicle?
Yeah, they told me some sort of situation is going on.
You are?
My name is Big P.
That's Big P.
I mean, Big P, I'm figuring, you know, this guy's would be like my son. Big, monstrous, you know, Big P.
Listen, Percy.
Percy? Don't use my government name.
The situation is, your friends, they came in my yard and started a fight with my dad and my brother.
I want to know what I can do to get my vehicle back.
There's nothing you can do. You didn't pay the bank. It's not yours. You don't own it. Bye-bye, car.
Everybody wants to pay after it's too late. This guy has been running from the bank for over 6 months.
Look. I feel lonely like blank pages. I see people look at laughter and then change faces, yeah. And now I'm the best that you ever saw because I'm about the ball. You wonder why my name is Big P? Well, I'ma tell you, even though you big, see? See, here's the situation. I'm the man, and no matter what you say, I'm I want my damn car right now before my boys go inside all up, and that's the situation. Done.
Well, you're broke,
done.
And that's a joke, and that's why your friends, they almost choked. I can rhyme too. I can rhyme too.
That was good. It was a very tense situation with my father. The comedy part of everything, you know, ended up bringing us back right back together.
That was a good rhyme.
I could be a rapper.
That was my worst part of my 19-hour day.
I'm so fly.
I done had it. I done had enough.
I love you.
Ow!
Tremont, are you there with the car, ma'am?
Hi, Robbie, I got a tow for you. You need to go to the Townhouse Hotel. There's a taxi in the loading zone. Go see valet.
10-4, Christy.
Taxi in the loading zone, en route. There you go, valet.
Hey, man, I got a taxi parked in the loading dock, and I have all these trucks that need to make deliveries. Can you get it out of there for me?
Got you.
Thanks, man.
Parking and loading zones, man, is a big, big no-no over here on the beach. You got the food and beverages for the hotels. You got people coming and going.
I got you. No problem. You're welcome.
Hey, what are you doing?
Hey, Papa, I had to take a taxi, man.
Dude, I'm sorry, but I just parked here for not even 10 minutes. I went to look for this guy that's supposed to take to the airport, and he left his luggage in my trunk, man. I waited for him for, like, you know, 20 minutes, and he hasn't come downstairs, so I went to look for him.
Listen, Papa, I already got your car on the hook. You're going to have to pay the drop fee, which is $115.
If I had that money, I would have given it to you.
I know that the taxi driver's just trying to do his job, but I've got to do a job, too. Somebody's got to pay.
Can you wait? Can you hold up and not
yeah,
live?
Yeah, that's
what
fine.
What the hell's going on
where you
here?
Been, man?
What do you where I've been? We walked around the whole block looking for you.
Dude,
you've
been gone for 20 minutes.
I told you to stay put. What's the problem?
Why you take the cab if you know that you weren't ready
I
to
I told
go?
You to stay put. We'd be that's back. Guys, we came guys, back. Guys. So why
don't
you move down the block?
I don't make money by being parked.
He was parked in the loading zone.
Why are you parked in the loading zone?
Because I went to look for you. It's your fault,
man. Why are you going to look for me?
You've been gone for 20 minutes.
Do you mind just get our bags?
Nothing comes out.
What do you mean nothing comes out? Bags are in trunk.
It's company policy. I am liable for everything that happens to that car. And until I get my money, nobody's coming inside that vehicle.
Unless I collect the 115 and I get the driver's license and registration.
Give me the driver's license and registration.
I have the license, but who's going to pay for it? Because I don't have that kind
who's
of cash.
Who's going to pay for it? The person whose car is getting towed is going to pay
yeah,
for it.
Yeah, but I mean, I was waiting for you.
You
I was trying to be nice. I could have left your luggage in the street.
So you got
to
take
my bags, please?
No,
so,
what?
Sir, listen, I can't do it.
So you're basically
and
a thief stealing my bags?
Yes, I'm stealing your bags.
You're stealing
sir.
My bags. Yes. What do you mean you can't? You press the button, you give me my bags, you get this money. I don't care. It's between you. It's on you guys.
You know what?
I'm on vacation. I'm just trying to get to the airport.
It doesn't work like that.
I'm going to get my bags. I'll call the cops.
Listen, I'm out of here.
When are you out of here? You're out of here? You're out of here? Yeah. Give me my bags. You
know no, bro, nobody ever calls me a thief. So understand
give
that.
Give me my bags.
Hey, yeah, come right on, now. Man. You gotta move the truck.
Give me my bags.
I'm a thief.
Give me my bags
I'm
right
a thief.
Now.
I'm a thief. I'm the one playing by the rules. And if you don't want to play by these rules, I'm out of there.
Sir, I have a flight to catch. Please give me my bags.
Right now.
Off this car now. Give me my bags.
Okay.
Face.
Well, you want to call me a thief? Call me a thief, bro. Now let's see my ass back at Tremont. They pay dope.
Wrong, man.
Get the car
listen,
ready,
to
right?
I'm trying to conduct some business here. You want to shut up for a
well,
second?
I want
to shut up.
You want to flight the cat?
You're a You ain't done with me.
Wow.
I just get my bags from this taxi. Don't ask me how this taxi driver parked in the loading zone. I never heard of a cab getting towed. You towed his cab. Don't ask me why. The guy refused to give me the bags. I need the bags. They're in the back of this cab. We have a flight to catch in about 45, 50 minutes, literally.
It's 250.
Okay, can you do a payment plan or something?
They don't do that today.
It's my property. Pay for it. It's my bags. I don't have that kind of money.
Who shows up to work without money? How do you get people change?
This is when I just started my shift.
So basically, you're holding my bags hostage for $250.
Unfortunately, when it's
home.
In the vehicle,
damn it,
it's part of the vehicle.
You're a piece of garbage. It's $250.
Get, you know, the cow, and I'll take it to the airport for free. I mean,
you take me to the airport for free as I just paid $250? Open up the gate.
So I just get another registration.
Open up the gate, please.
Go ahead.
No deal with these wonderful people.
Boy. Okay. Oh, this is going to be fun.
Shut up.
Okay. Go, come on.
I'm a jerk? What type of cab gets towed? Are you the owner?
No, I run this shop.
Yeah, you're a hole.
Yeah, well.
We're a bunch of scam artists.
I call a lot of things.
Freaking moron. Unbelievable. Only in South Florida. Unbelievable.
I missed my flight. You'll be spending many days doing my attorney. Screw you. And look at this. Drop the bags, idiot. You caused all this. Dad, how'd you get us into this situation? What's wrong with you?
All right, bud, you're good to go.
Yeah. Write down the number. Write down the number.
I gotta put a pen.
Write down the number to the cab. Find out the boss's name now, ASAP.
Hang on.
Oh
my God, my shoes were in there.
What's going on here? What's going
on? She's throwing our stuff.
Hey, those are valuable. Who gave you permission to throw my stuff, huh? Open up the trunk.
No, wait.
Hey, call the cops. There's another bag in there. Open the truck now.
It's called 911.
Open the truck.
Whoa,
whoa. Close the gate!
What
are you doing, idiot? Letting him go, my bag?
Bye. Have a nice day.
Hey!
I can't believe
that
he did
awesome.
That.
Why'd you let him out? What?
I'm done with him. I pay.
You're done with him. You pay? Oh, you make your money? Now,
no, you're
I'm
right.
Calling
he
cops
stole
on you.
Your
hey,
okay,
excuse so me?
This,
you shut up.
Hey,
my
father.
This is my father. You this whole
situation. Hey.
Come on.
Come on.
You
need to go. Stop.
You can insult me, you can spit at me, you can throw things at my truck. I don't care. But as soon as you insult my family, all bets are off.
It's all right.
Go.
My lawyer's gonna know about this. It's all right.
Open the gate.
My lawyer's gonna hurt you more.
That's fine.
I'll be back.
Open the gate. I'm proud of Robbie today. He did the right thing with the tow, and he defended his sister. Go make me some money. Go make me some money without the hassle.
What's up, homeboy? You jump on my boy?
You poked me so many times, I'm gonna poke you back for probably twice as hard.
Got you.
Stop. Right now on South Beach Tow.
You have a Jamila three-tier buttercream cake. I'm about to put my foot up this. I will hit some or I'll do anything.
The boat's parked in the back. It looks like it's gonna be an easy channel pick.
Hey, yo, what are you doing? That's my boat.
This is my lot. We've had it here for 10 years.
Let's go get them, man. Payback's the. You slip, I grip. That's what I'm talking about. My name is Jerome. Everybody call me J Money. 29 a base. I'm 51 loaded with a Chrysler minivan.
So I get a call from Jerome. He's towing a silver van from an alley. Hazard lights are on.
If they out here parking the alley, emergency vehicle can't get through here. It might be a person out here having a heart attack, falling off their stairways or something like that. So if you slipping out here in this alley, I got to tow you.
Tremont.
Hello.
Hello.
Did you just tow a silver van off of the dock on beach right now? It has your lights on.
Do you know where you were parked, ma'am?
On the beach, over there on the ocean. If my hazard lights were on, it was an emergency. How can you tow a van that's having an emergency?
Well, ma'am, if you were illegally parked and they had me remove the car, there's nothing I can do.
Did you know that I had one of my cakes up in there?
I didn't know you made cakes, ma'am. I deal with cars, not cakes.
Okay, but I just had to run in for 30 seconds. It was no big deal.
Unfortunately.
He's here, buttercream cake up in there with my doggone name on it, riding on this, and you over here touring my doggone vehicle.
She's a cake baker on the way to a wedding, and we officially are in possession of a three-tiered buttercream something or another cake, and she is mad.
First, you need to put my cake in the doggone shade or refrigerator or something, and you better move my cake.
Awesome. All right, well, your cake will be sitting in your van when you get here, ma'am, all right? I can't go in your car. Not that I'm trying to be mean, but we do not allow anyone to go in anyone's car.
It looked like a wedding cake in here, like they were having a wedding thing or something going on today. And it's mush. It's to the door. Oh, man, they gonna be really pissed. I can't do nothing about it. That's their fault. They better go back and make them another cake. Hey, you do me a favor, you can sign my name on it, because I just got another one, baby.
Is there really cake in the van?
It's mush. It's already smushed.
How smushed?
It's all on the windows and everything.
Oh, what? I like how you're walking away, so you're gonna make me handle this crazy lady?
I'm only gonna go mark him on the board, and I'll take care of the crazy lady, no problem. Here at Tremont Towing, we have a competition. The driver who brings us the most tows every 3 months gets a real hefty cash bonus.
Well, I could be sleeping for a month and you'll never catch up to me, man.
Come on, man. I'm the best out here.
A whole month? Yeah, I'm the best.
Hello? I got a cake. I need to get it. Hello?
1 minute, please.
Anybody working here?
No.
Hello?
Hi.
Hi. Are you the girl I spoke to on the phone?
That depends. What kind of car are you here for?
I gotta get my cake. It's in a silver minivan?
That would be me.
Turns out that our lovely lady cake maker has no money.
It's gonna be $2.25 to get the van
out. I'm sorry, excuse me.
Ma'am, if
you want... You towed my truck with the hazard lights on. Okay. Ain't no way in hell I'm paying that.
If you want your van, you gotta pay. At the end of the day, this is a business. The price is what the price is. They're non-negotiable. It's
okay, do you understand that you have a Jamila three-tier buttercream cake sitting up in that van, and if it melts, my ass is screwed.
Now, she has to call the person who hired her to come here and save her ass.
How much do I owe you?
It's $2.25.
All right. Before I pay for this, I need to know where the van was stolen.
It was on Ocean. She don't have to tell you nothing else. Just pay her the $2.25. It was on Ocean.
It was in the alley off of 13th and Ocean.
You were at your boyfriend's house when you had a delivery to make? That ain't no damn emergency.
That was an emergency.
All right, we gonna talk about this. We just gonna go get the cake right now, okay? All right, here you go. It's in the van.
Yes, it's in the
van. It's been in the van this whole damn time? I hope you buckled that cake up.
Of course
I buckled. That cake better be buckled up or your ass is fired. Open the door. What the You
damn
didn't
it.
Even cake.
I did buckle the cake. They must have moved when they told my...
I'm looking at it. That's not going to work. You got to be the reception in 45 minutes. Look at this damn cake.
I know what time I have to be there. If this not told my car, then we would not have a problem.
I thought I saw her mad before. I saw a whole new side of mad.
You see what you're doing? You see what you're doing? Calm down.
All right.
Ma'am. Yeah, call daddy.
You don't touch me. Like, you don't get to touch me.
I'm about to put my foot up.
Ma'am.
Ma'am.
Touch me. Do you understand
you me?
I will
me,
hit
ma'am.
Like you any day. Well, any day. I done handle boys bigger than you in the doggone squad. I can handle. Okay. Come on, boy. Let's go, man. Let's go, man.
Ma'am, you need to stop. You need to stop. Okay. At this point, I'm going to call the cops.
What am I going
to
do?
Bring the freaking cake inside. We'll see what we can do to fix it, and go from there.
Because I done asked your ass over hours ago to take that
and
dog
I
on
told
place.
You you could have.
Excuse
I
me, you ain't. You didn't tell me. I asked your ass a long time ago to take that cake and put it in there. Girl, I'm trying not to hurt you right now. I swear to God I am.
Jamila.
What?
Calm down. You got 45 minutes to get the cake there. Fix the cake.
Okay, but see, here's the problem. Because, see, you want me to calm down, but your ass said you ain't paying me.
All right.
Are you going to pay me?
If you fix the cake, we'll work it out. Let's go. We got to get out of here. You got 45 minutes.
I'm Jamila. I can fix the cake.
All right.
You going to pay me?
If you fix the cake, let's do it.
You gonna pay me.
Come on,
you
let's
are
go.
Going to pay me. I'll see you.
Hopefully she won't hit none of the cars inside the place.
That's what I'm hoping.
Jamila,
yeah,
what the
works
hell?
Really well. Now I think there's gonna be a bigger problem.
You just dropped the damn cake!
Goodbye. Please don't come back. Today we're repossessing a go-fast boat. We have to be very, very careful.
Probably so. Drug dealer, huh?
We got a gun, bro.
Today we're repossessing a boat, a 32-foot Scarab, commonly known as a go-fast boat. The area that we are repossessing the boat from is one of the most expensive on Miami Beach. But most people that have go-fast boats have go-fast boats for one reason. They're planning to outrun the authorities. Normally, I take my son for a job like this, but he's just been screwing up too much.
Yo, Big B ain't paid his bills, Blair. We're taking the car.
I'm telling him repair work, and you're telling him repo?
You don't get it, do you?
It wasn't working over there, man.
You need to shut up and listen, or find another career.
My dad told me I'm not going with him on the repo, the go fast boat. I'm kind of pissed off. He's taking Eddie. He can't compare to what I do.
Eddie, this is the marina where the towboat's gonna be. I know it's early in the morning. Yeah, I know it's early in the morning for you, man.
I hate getting up early in the morning.
I need your game on. I need it heavily on.
I'm tired, bro.
Yeah, I know you're tired, but think of the money you're gonna be making when we get this boat. The best time to repossess a boat is early in the morning. There's not a lot of people around. There's not a lot of people hanging out on their docks. We can get in, we can get out without problems. All right, you can see it's a huge mansion. The boat's parked in the back. It looks like it's gonna be an easy channel pick. One of the most dangerous things we do, but also one of the ones we get paid the most to do. Make sure you check everything when you get on that boat.
Robert was explaining to me about tying the knots on the boat and putting it on the dock and checking the cabin. To be honest, I was tired. I don't remember what he said, bro.
When I was doing background on this guy, I can't find anything on him. I don't know where his money comes from, so that gets me a little suspicious when the guy is living in a $3 million mansion.
Probably a drug dealer, huh?
Yeah, well, there's always a possibility, because you know, the drug dealer's favorite thing is a go-fast boat. Whatever the case may be, we have to be very, very careful. I don't want you to get hurt. I definitely don't want me to get hurt. We're gonna go in stealth. We good with that?
All right.
All right, cool. Game on, baby, game on. When we're repossessing a boat, we have to have our own boat in order to pull the other boat with us. You ain't getting sick on me, are you?
Doesn't look choppy, so I'm
all right. Good?
I'm all right.
All right, good, good. It comes with its own set of unique problems. We're on water. Unless you can swim real well, there's no place to run.
I think that's it over there, bro.
Hey, man, you know something? I think you're right. Nice and easy, very quietly. Let me get up. As Eddie climbs onto the scarab, I'm watching the house, I'm watching our surroundings, making sure everything is good, making sure nobody's around. Tie it off. I start creeping out of there, and I'm saying, thank God, I think I'm gonna be able to get out of here.
Hey, yo, what are you doing? That's my boat. Stealing my boat. Boat back.
You gotta repossess, bro.
Payments.
Hey, Rob, hurry up and get out of here, Rob. Let's get out of here, bro.
My first instinct was hit the throttle, get out of there as quick as you can. But unfortunately, I'm in a small towboat. If I punch it, I'm gonna break the rope.
Stop the boat right there. Stop.
Easy.
Get out of my boat. You're not gonna stop it.
Oh, what's up?
Watch yourself. Watch yourself.
You got a gun, bro.
Claudia.
Stop.
What? Doing on the boat?
Dad, what's going on?
Bro, this shit is f***ing crazy, bro.
You didn't check the damn cabin, did you?
Oh, you forgot to check the boat?
Don't even touch my daughter, bro. What are you doing, Claudia? You naked.
I wasn't sleeping here, Dad. What, who are you?
I'm a repossession agent, and your boat is getting repossessed.
Eddie, you really need to go with the gun, Eddie.
I am, bro. You're supposed to go.
Why are they repossessing their boat, Dad?
That's bull.
Repossession
my ass.
Yo, what's up, bro?
Come back inside.
Then this big guy comes out and it all started making sense to me.
What he's doing on my boat? I told you not to see this big. Get the out of there, Claudia.
He's yelling and screaming. I'm just looking for a way not to get shot.
We didn't do anything, bro. Yo, put the gun down.
My boat.
Hey, bro, I didn't sign up for this, bro.
I have a family, I have a wife, I have kids, I have an extended family at Tremont. So dying over towing a boat, it ain't worth it.
Please, no, I'm not gonna get over there. That boat is not even loaded.
It's not loaded?
Then his daughter says something that I just couldn't believe. Mama won't let him have bullets. I'm gonna call the Marine Patrol, bud. Your ass is gonna go to jail, bud. I'm the guy who's repossessing your boat because you didn't pay for it. You have your ass arrested for having that gun on the water. Once I told him, I'm calling the Marine Patrol, I'm gonna have you arrested, he got scared, went and got his daughter.
Let's go, Claudia!
And got the hell away from us. Got to check the cabin, didn't you?
No, yeah, I forgot.
Yeah, you forgot about that part.
It won't happen again, though.
Just like my son, it ain't gonna happen again.
Was it just as bad or was it?
They almost capped your dad in the ass.
So I'm not. That's awesome.
Well, you know something? Time for you all both to go back to work and bring me some real money. And try not to bring me any drama, just the money, please. That's all. I hope I make my 58th birthday.
Yo, man, what the? This is my lot. Y'all gotta drop.
Hey, man, who your truck, man?
I'll take both y'all on, Blair.
You want your
it's gonna be my
Listen, all I got right now in cash is 125.
That ain't gonna do it, guy. It's 250.
I can't believe you're trying to charge me 250.
That's right, 250.
Well, I don't even know how to sleep at night.
I sleep during the day.
Robbie, Robbie, I got a tow waiting for you.
In the North Beach lot. The North Beach lot, an abandoned car, no decal. Been there for a few days, book and book.
Ben, what happened?
Abandoned vehicles are the easiest. In and out, quick, can't ask for anything better.
Oh, this ain't happening right now.
Yo, man, what the f***? This gotta keep on happening, bro.
What?
Finest Towing is one of our biggest competitors. They poach our lots, they steal our tows, man. They're just a bunch of thugs.
Now, why don't you move your truck so we can go? We're already hooked up. We got a call.
Bro, see that sign right there? Come on, towing right there.
That's our contract now.
This is my lot. We've had it here for 10 years. I'm trying to stay calm in this situation. Because I know if I don't, my father's going to be pissed. Listen, I'm going to make a phone call, man. I'm going to call my old man.
Because that's what you're doing.
Because he knows Finest. And we've had problems with them before.
Somebody calling their daddy a grown-ass man. Daddy.
Huh? Tremont.
Hey, we got a situation over here, man.
What's the matter?
All right, I got these guys, two guys here, bro, from Finest. They got this car hooked up. I'm not letting them leave, man.
Hey, man, here, move wait.
I know the owner of Finest. We have some history together. I'm figuring he must have hired some new drivers, and they're up to no good.
I don't want you to get into an altercation with these guys. You understand me?
They're already starting, man. I got the truck blocking them. They can't get out of the lot.
First thing you need to do is stay in the truck. Just block the entrance. But stay in the truck.
You better move that truck before we beat your ass.
I'm pretty much outmanned right here, man.
I'm grabbing Jerome right now.
Jerome, we gotta go.
Hey, but man, come on, baby, time is money. Yeah, it is what it is, pussy boy.
My father told me to stay in the truck, but you know, I like to handle things myself.
Get your fat ass out the way.
Here we go. Hey, man, I just talked to my old man. Y'all gonna have to drop this car, man. Listen, y'all dropping this car.
Hey, man, you made the call, man. Go on ahead and move the truck, man.
My old man said y'all got.
Bring your daddy out here.
Hey, he's coming, Blair.
Bring him
in, somebody else. I got all my boys coming.
Hey, man. Hey, man.
Hey, Blair.
Look, man. Let me tell him, man.
Hey.
What I need to do, move your
don't
truck.
Don't touch me, bro.
Move your truck, man.
No, you need. No, you too.
Hold on, man.
Bro, y'all. You poke me so many times, I'm going to poke you back, but probably twice as hard.
I'll take both y'all on, Blair.
Do it.
Give him that. Let's go, come on. Hurry up.
Oh, oh, oh. I can hear everything happening, man, but there wasn't much I could do. I was so dizzy from getting clipped behind the head. Thank God they didn't steal the truck. I gathered myself, I called my father.
Hello?
These guys just jumped me, man.
Oh, you didn't do it with them. Are you okay?
Just get over here. How far are you?
Jerome and I are on the way. We'll be here shortly.
Robbie's a big boy, but if those guys from Finest hurt my son, there's hell to pay.
He's here. Let's go see how he's doing.
Get out of the truck. Let me look at you. Come on.
Damn, that's a brother to me. You know what I'm saying? That's my dog.
Bye.
What's up, you straight?
Yeah, they caught me from behind, man.
You okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, you ready to go?
Bruise up a little bit. What's up, man? Let's go get them, man.
If they're gonna come over the bridge to get my toes, I'm gonna go to their place and I'm gonna get it back. I know you're pissed and I know you are too, but follow my lead, all right? I don't wanna have to get into a if it's unnecessary. If I can settle it with him, we settle it with him. You understand me? You too, big boy. Follow my lead. All right, let's go. Binus is in Miami over the bridge. It's in what I call the third world country.
Rolling from South Beach to Overtown, better known as OT. That's the worst neighborhood over there. You ride through there, you better be ready to shake something down when you ride in the OT like that.
Larry! I need you out here, Larry!
Let's go!
Larry! Yo, Larry!
What's the problem?
Man, you know what the problem is. You guys got over to the beach, you got one of our cars, and then, of course, they jumped my son.
Look at the attitude you're all bringing over here right now.
If it was your son, you would have the same attitude.
Yeah, but right now, this is not the way to come to my place.
Man, I was ready to bite something. I would just go chew them out and spit them out.
Leave your cameras out here. You and I can step inside and talk. We don't need all this in front of everybody.
Everybody stay outside.
Stay right here, guys.
Be cool.
In the dough now, what's up? Dope, not. What's good, man? What's up, homeboy? You jump on my boy?
That's how it is, bro.
That's how it is.
Yeah, it takes two of y'all.
I guarantee you can't hit me from the back like you did. Man. You ain't gonna say, what's up with that?
I ain't gotta hit you from the back, partner. I hit you from the front.
Man. What's up, man,
huh? Bro,
I ain't got time to be rapping with you, boy. I ain't got time to be rapping with you. Hey, I want you to see
you. Get him, boy.
Huh? What's up now? What's up right now?
Hey,
break it up. Break it up.
Get out! Stay! Get out!
Stay.
Get
out. Get out.
You think this the way
to
do business?
Huh?
Not.
That's the way I do business.
All hell has broken loose outside. We told you all, chill. We're the owners. You work for us. Jerome, you get in the truck and you get the car. He's giving us the car. We're getting the hell out of here, getting back to the base. Larry and I have an agreement. This stuff is not going to happen again. I'm giving him the North Beach lot, and Finest is going to stop poaching our cars.
He's opening up the gate. Get the car. You! That's get enough. In my car. Dead.
Go to your room.
Get in my car.
Is he that naive that he's going to make a truce with this dirty? Are you serious?
Daddy'll give you a lollipop when you get home.
I'll give your ass a lollipop, boy.
Yo! Car.
You heard, Daddy.
If he really thinks if I see these guys again, we're going to go have a beer. Nah, man, it ain't going to be like that, man. You know, I'm going to let them have this.
I don't care if you don't like it, but that's how it's going to be.
Bro, this is the f- I've ever seen you make.
Hey, sometimes you got to give a little to take back.
Far from over, bro.
Right now on South Beach Tow.
You guys gotta wait outside. Robbie, Jerome! Okay, seriously? You can't throw a music video here.
I forgot where I was at. Well, I thought I was at the club somewhere.
Jerome, do you want a job?
Wait.
I'm repossessing the car.
That's what I gave you the money.
How could
you? Yo, ma'am.
There's no way you're gonna leave this lot.
I need you to open up the gate.
There was no time. There was too much stuff going on, bro.
Robbie, there's always time to do it the right way. You're an amazing driver, but you're becoming a problem.
Who took my Camaro?
Don't.
Me and Park, why don't you come
excuse
on
me.
Here, huh?
Hi, Eddie, come on, dude. Dad.
What's up, dog?
What the hell happened?
Huh?
Today, we're repossessing a 2008 Mercedes S550. Nice car, a lot of money. They're 4 months behind, almost $6,000. My son spotted it, now we're gonna sit on it, and we're gonna wait for the opportunity to get it. Number one, I want to make sure we get in and out of here without no confrontations. My son is the best driver I have. but he's also the most stubborn one. Sometimes his carefree attitude can get us in real trouble.
Yo, Big P ain't paid his bills, Blair. We're taking the car.
What's wrong with you? You don't get it, do you?
It wasn't working over there, man.
Done 2 repos. I done 1,000. You need to shut up and listen.
I've been bringing my son into repossessions because that's what he wants to do. The only way you're gonna get your feet wet is by jumping in the water. If you wanna move up in this company, you need to listen, you need to learn.
Here's the address, park over here on the side over here, and let's see if somebody opens up that gate.
I want the gate pegged.
Got it, ain't no big deal.
It ain't no big deal. It's never a big deal, but I want that done.
But I got it.
I need this car.
Oh, we
like
both
I do. Need money. Money.
Money's a beautiful thing. We were posted up off to the side. We saw somebody coming into the house.
All right, nice and easy.
I'm gonna follow him in.
Don't go too far. They're gonna be blocking us. Let me see if I can get them to move.
Yeah.
Excuse me, ma'am. Hi, how are you? I'm the tow truck picking up the car. It's going to the repair shop. They had a check engine light thing. I'm gonna take it to the Mercedes dealer. Yes, please, if you would, could you please move the car over this side over here, please? Thank you.
Give me that thumbs up, man. Give me that thumbs up. There we go. Got the thumbs up. Let's get turned around now.
They believe me. They parked the car over to the other side. Here comes my son, hooking up the car.
Oh, wow, that's a tight fit.
Excuse me.
I'll be right with you, ma'am.
Wait, what are you doing?
Excuse me,
ma'am.
What are you doing?
I'm repossessing the vehicle.
No,
you gotta pay for your car. If you don't pay for your car, it's gonna be repossessed by us. Start maneuvering yourself out of here, ma'am. I don't wait all day for this. You gotta get away from the car.
No,
gotta get away from the car, ma'am. Stay away from the car.
Hey, how you doing? Wait, stop, please.
I'm repossessing the car.
Why, what happened?
Because you didn't pay it for 4 months. The bank now owns it. I'm repossessing the car. I mean, you miss one payment, maybe. 2, oh. But when you get to 3, 4, 5 payments, no, guy, you're not paying for the car.
4 months? That's I gave you the money. What are you doing?
Money. I go shopping with the money. I don't pay for cars.
I already have possession of the vehicle.
You know what? There's no way you're gonna leave this lot.
They closed the gate, and now I'm pissed at Robbie because I asked him to peg the gate.
Okay, let's talk a little.
I need you to open up the gate, sir. The car goes with me right now. That's it.
What's this?
That's your name.
Man, I'm not gonna.
That ain't gonna change my car.
I'm gonna take your car, sir.
I'm taking your car. What is your problem?
You're the problem.
You wanna
you're
make
the
it a problem?
Problem? No, you
wanna
the
make it a problem?
You're the problem.
You can make it a problem.
I'll tell you what. Take the car and take her with you.
What?
I wash my hands. I don't give a. Go ahead. Gate's opening.
Let's get the hell out of here.
You guys go.
You fat. You are not stealing this car.
You are not going where you please. Hey, what are you doing?
The minute you put your hands on one of my drivers, they are free to do whatever they have to do to protect themselves. Let's go.
Wait. Oh my God. Don't get up.
Let's go.
Don't get up.
Come on.
I asked you to peg the gate.
There was too much stuff going on, bro.
Bobby, there's always time to do it the right way.
In this business, shortcuts mean nothing but trouble. We take the time to do it right. What happens if people have guns? The only thing you could be holding is your nuts in your hand. You want to move up in this business. You don't always want to be a driver. You don't always want to be an agent, okay? You want to be the one running the show. It's up to you to move up, and you start running the company, and you start making the money. That's what I want.
This, I did not accept.
You don't take a card.
Where am I going to scan it?
His ass. You should swipe his ass because he's a fuck ass. The money I am.
So you got
it? What the fuck?
Do
it. Do it. Hey,
you, get in your truck. You can't cooperate, then get your out of here.
Tell you how much I love you.
No, get away from me. Huh? Get away from me.
Like this.
No, but these are, if these are crumbled and I can't read them, you don't get paid. So stop molestando me. Stop it! Me and my brother have a very love-hate relationship. Sometimes we get along, sometimes we want to murder one another. Try again. Go ahead.
Answer that phone.
Tremont.
Yeah, hi. I've got a neon green BMW
sitting
right in my valet spot. It's on
Ocean
and 9th. It's the Waldorf Tower.
You said a green BMW?
Neon green. Very bright green. You'll see it. I'll be standing out there until you get here.
And what's your name, honey?
Eugene. Yeah.
All right, honey. I'll send them right over. Stop it. Go get the car. Go.
What is that?
Freaking 9th and Ocean, the Waldorf. Go.
Yeah. I love my sister to death, but I love annoying her more. I annoy her so I can get a different call and she can kick me out of the office. So I'm gonna go ahead, but this thing, the sunroof is open so we can get right in.
Hey, man.
Hey, just across the street, man.
Let's go across the street. Standing blocking traffic. You're blocking traffic.
We need to get that car off the back of that, please.
All right, who am I talking to? Whose car is it?
My name is Reginald, man. I'm Butter's manager.
Hi, how you doing? I'm Toast.
So we're trying to shoot a video of him. It's our location. It's our last set. You know, we're trying to get it before the sun go down. We got like 10 minutes, 20 minutes tops. We just need a couple shots of Butter rapping in front of the car. It's a rental. And then, you know, we're gonna be out.
All right, listen, you're parked in the valet route. You need a permit to park there, especially if you're filming out here.
A permit?
These people think they're gonna shoot a music video on a busy street, illegally parked in somebody's valet stand. It ain't happening.
How much it costs? How much
it's gonna be $115.
$115? Yeah.
How much he said it was?
Listen, here, $20, or you can buy all the ho-hos you want.
What the f***? You supposed to be some big time person, you can't even pay him?
But I am big.
You here
I got,
for?
Your manager
are you serious?
Got this.
Hey,
I got.
I want to hear it.
Here you go. $115 right there, bro.
This I did not accept. It's cash only.
Who don't take a card? What kind of business is this?
Where am I gonna scan it?
His ass. You should swipe his ass because he's a boss ass.
I would feel kind of bad for messing up Butter's video, but you know what? That manager she has, that's not the right way to handle business.
What the hell is going on? Just move the car.
Who is this?
I'm the valet manager.
I gotta give them the opportunity to do a drop. They came over. I'm
just
taking a car.
I'm
taking a car.
Thank
listen, you.
You
got 115 or no?
Bring it out right now.
Thank you, I'll show you where I live. I wanna take you home. You got your fat ass better go behind and get my car. You better go get that right off.
Hey, big man, hold on.
This is my
go
favorite
around, guys.
Car.
I gotta go.
I'm gonna make a new rap song about your ass. It's gonna call fat mother.
Don't forget
that
same trick.
Gosh,
Butter,
y'all broke
it. My name's Butter. Butter, you look like Crisco.
I salute to that. That's a big canoe, boy.
You can't film a music video here. You gotta go too. You ruined my video.
Oh, you want to talk to me?
Yeah, I want to talk to you.
Hey, what are you doing? Come on, dude. Come on. Dad!
Dog, you would have loved the toe I did today.
What was up?
A rapper.
Counter rappers.
a wannabe rapper.
One of those, huh?
Yeah, man. But hey, boy, she thick, though.
Boy, you don't even know what thick is, man.
Okay. She got some double D's. She got an ass bigger than dad's.
I never looked at your dead ass.
How you doing? We need to get our car. It's a lime green BMW. It's a rental.
Butter's favorite color.
This is Butter.
Hey, how you doing?
All right.
Oh, now you're gonna get up.
Oh, yeah, well, I salute to that. Okay. Got some big canonies, boy. You ain't fit on the way you were there?
Dog.
Man, you a sucker, man.
Oh, man, that ain't my time, dog.
The agreement is in the car.
Okay, but whose name is it under?
It's under my name, Reggie.
Okay, I'll let you inside since it's in your name to get the rental agreement, okay? Just meet me at the gate.
That's Butter.
She's kind of butter.
I butter
up. Okay. Got some popcorn?
That's it,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
You guys gotta wait outside. You guys gotta. Robbie, Jerome!
Yo, Terrence, get the camera. Butter, get on the front of the car.
Yeah. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yeah. Okay, seriously? I'm sorry. Yeah. But you can't film a music video here. No, sit down. This is a tall one. No, not my kid.
That was fire. Yeah, Butter. Who did they?
Okay, too bad, honey.
Shut up, baby. Shut up. Shut up, baby girl. Huh?
I'll be
playing. Hey, look here.
Okay, two options.
Oh, I forgot where I was at. Well, I thought I was at the club somewhere.
Christy.
Jerome, do you want a job? Do you want a job?
You want to work for me, baby.
Hey, my man is good. You need to get him on your...
What's your name?
Dude, you got to go, too. You got to go, too. Reginald, you ruined my video. I can't stand you.
Let's go.
It's all good.
Let's go.
I think you're fired.
Oh, okay.
Honey, you're too classy for that. Come on. Let's go.
You messed up your video looking like a good year blimp. You need to ride your little pony out of here.
Can't rap anyway.
Better rap a Christmas gift.
Whatever.
I bet you unwrap a burger and put it in your mouth.
That's exactly what you always talk about.
Bye. Peace out. Looking like a fake Lil' Kim.
Whatever.
And Angela Bassett hound with you.
Oh, shut the f*** up, you fat
f***. Whatever. Whatever.
At least somebody had a good night tonight. Jerome got to dance with the ladies.
Got me a free dance.
How did that dance go?
Ooh, we're taking it nice and slow, baby. Damn, Papa Chulo, I want to come and do ya. Ooh, I ride it like a pony.
I need quiet time after that. Try and give me cars without problems.
I'm gonna go find me another hostel room for my boy Money. That's how we do, shake and bake.
Tremont.
Hey, what's up? It's Philip from Wine Boutique and Spirits. We got a yellow Camaro that's been parked in the back for a long time. Can you guys send somebody down to get it?
All right, and the parking's in the back there, right?
Yeah, correct. It's a yellow Camaro. You can't miss it. It's ugly as
All right, honey. I'll send him right over.
Hey, I got a tow in for you. 1328 Olsen. You're picking up a yellow Camaro. You copy?
Christy, bro, I don't know what's wrong with her, man. She talks to me like I'm a 5-year-old.
Earth to Eddie, are you out there?
I'm the best driver at Tremont, man. I deserve respect.
Eddie, do you call me?
A yellow Camaro, 1328 Alton.
I heard you, Christy.
Well, I wouldn't know that unless you answered me.
Maybe I would answer you if you would say please.
As far as Eddie's concerned, he's such a dick.
Why, honey?
Eddie has no respect. He never answers me when I call him on the radio. He gives me nothing but a hard time. All he does is argue with me. I've had it up to here.
Eddie can come across like a villain, but he does produce for me. If he couldn't do that, I'd toss his ass out the door so quick and make his head spin.
You know what the reality here is? If you look at that board over there, you're gonna see he has more hash marks than any driver I have there.
on. There's a boy right there. Homeboy. This is a rear-wheel drive car. Easy to hook it up. I gotta tell you, bro, today I'm in a real f***ed up mood. And the guy that owns this car should be happy. He didn't have any confrontations with me, man.
You had a mind fart or something today?
No, what?
Why? What are you wearing?
A Tremont shirt.
No, you're not wearing a Tremont shirt that we wear now.
I don't like that shirt, bro.
It's a DOT certified shirt for your safety.
I don't like these green shirts, bro. They're like so bright. You're just out there, bro.
You're not privileged here. Just like I gotta wear this shirt, you gotta wear your shirt.
Bro, I don't like being like everybody else. And you know what? The safety. I take care of myself.
If you don't put the shirt on, you can f*** your job.
Yo, I got a Camaro, man. My was taken from behind the wine place.
I don't
know. Man, this is bull. They're gonna just come and take my like that?
I don't know how long you were parked there, but I got called to pick it up. I'm just doing my job.
I parked there for a few minutes. What the man? I want my car right now. Right now.
Without license?
You guys are thieves, man.
Hey, Christy, don't forget to put me down on the board for now.
Christy don't keep track of all my toes, bro. And honestly, it's pissing me the off.
You can go inside and get
it. I got like six or seven more toes, and y'all don't even put me down.
Oh, hey, hey, hi. Do you not see me dealing with a customer?
I don't know about that, man.
Do you
man.
Not
you
see me dealing
me
with
myself.
A customer?
Yo, what the? You guys compete stealing cars?
No.
That's what the it sounds like. Hey, who took my Camaro?
What's the problem?
I want my back. That's what the
I'm back. You gotta pay for it,
that's the problem. I want my back.
You want my back?
Yo, give me my back, yo.
Don't.
Me, want you come on here, huh?
The last thing that I need is someone that's supposed to be on my side egging this guy on. Hey.
Open this gate. We're going to see what's up.
Oh, you want to talk to me?
Yeah, I want to talk to you.
Let's
what's
go.
Good?
Eddie,
let's go.
Come on. Eddie, you're not going outside.
Where's the clicker?
It doesn't matter. You're not going outside, Eddie. You don't invite trouble into your home. You keep that outside. Leave it be, dude. Let me handle it.
I got
Hey, go to the
Eddie,
gate.
Eddie, what are you doing? Hello? Eddie, you are not allowed. Stop.
Hey, let me go.
Eddie, don't be f***ing stupid. Come on, dude. Come on. Dad!
Open this gate. We're going to see what's up.
Oh, you want to talk to me?
Yeah, I want to talk to you.
Let's
what's
go
good?
Play,
Eddie,
go
let's go.
Come on. Eddie, don't be f***ing stupid. Come on, dude. Come on. Dad!
What's your problem, man?
What's up, dog?
What the
hell? What the
hell,
man?
Come on, serious?
Yo. Hey. Yo.
Yo, what are you doing?
Yo.
What are you doing? Bro?
Yo. Yo, come on. Guy, no.
Let me go.
No.
I want my
The customer actually hit Eddie first. So Eddie had every right to defend himself. But it could have been all avoided if he just walked away from the window.
Yo, come over here! Come over here!
What's your problem, bro?
Hey, Rob, get out of my face, man.
No, man.
What the problem, motherfucker, trying me like that?
I'm tired of him putting my father in all these predicaments.
Man, what's up, dog?
Keep on, bro.
I keep on doing on, you ain't gonna hurt Okay.
Stay here before the cops show up.
Burn.
You don't want to go to jail, man.
Burn.
Stop.
Burn.
All right?
So what you going to do about it? I'm in your face. You going to push me like you push him? Hey, you don't want none.
Huh?
You don't want none.
Dude, bro, you always putting my dad you in these situations.
You
ain't
your dad.
So you got
hey,
it?
What the
f***?
So
what you going to do?
Come on.
Do it. Do it.
You.
What's going on? You, get in your truck.
Pussy ass.
Get in your truck. Get in the office, Eddie.
You gotta always be standing behind your daddy and
man, what the f*** is wrong with you?
Ain't nothing wrong with
me. There's plenty of wrong with you.
Ain't
you know
wrong.
We don't need this f*** going on here now.
Nobody need to be trying
this
me,
This is
bro.
Not the thug world. This is the real world.
Man. All you Guys, do is see everything I do wrong, bro.
I've been giving you as much breaks as I can. You can't cooperate, then get your f*** out of here. You're an amazing driver, but you're becoming a f***ing problem.
I try to do right, but then you got like that trim.
If you would have just walked away from the window, nothing would have ever happened. That's as simple as that is.
You got it, bro.
Okay? And another thing, get the damn shirt on. And I mean right now. If you plan to work here, the next time I see you is with the shirt on. Simple.
You got it, bro.
I had to lay down the law with Eddie. He's way past my tolerance rate. If it happens again, I'm done with it.
Next time on South Beach Tub.
What the f*** you doing, man? That's my toe you got, man. I need you to drop that.
I knew this truce wasn't gonna work.
Hey!
Oh, here he comes.
Hey!
Hey! If you can.
You make life complicated.
Robert, where's my truck?
My lot, bud. You got $250?
What?
Previously on South Beach Tow.
Get him, boys!
Huh? Hey, break it up! Break it up!
Larry and I have an agreement. I'm giving him the North Beach lot, and Finest is gonna stop poaching our cars.
I don't care if you don't like it, but that's how it's gonna be.
Far from over, bro.
And right now.
What the hell is this? What the f you doing, man? That's my toe you got, man. I need you to drop that. Drop the car, baby.
Bro, hey.
Man, don't put your hands up.
What are you
gonna
do about
it? Call your again.
Ha ha! Booyah!
Got some scooters we need to tow.
I'll just go do it myself.
I don't like him going out into the field. He can get hurt.
You told us we could park here.
I never told you
to do
that.
Yeah, you did.
Touch me.
Don't
touch me.
Don't touch me.
We ain't talking to you.
Bro, look.
You're not gonna hurt me. Don't you understand
that? Wait.
Does Larry even know we have this yet?
I'm pretty sure he's making a phone call now.
Robert, where's my truck?
In my lot, bud. You got $250?
What? Always gonna create more problems and more problems between us.
It's 212, ma'am.
Excuse me?
212.
Ralphie on one.
Thank you. So she used her mother's handicap permit.
Yeah, to park closer to the club. Jerome came in here. And he's all, I need a raise. And I was like, so do I.
He wants a raise? Tell him to get a second job.
Tremont.
Hi, my name is Alex from Max Surface Bar and Grill, and I have a black BMW SUV in my spot. It's across from the Boca Training Club.
I know exactly where that is. Robbie.
Yeah, go ahead, Christy.
Robbie, I got a tow for you at the Max Up Bar and Grill. A black BMW SUV. The spot's right across Lincoln Lane in front of Boca Tanning.
10-4, Christy, 10-4. Black BMW. All right, here we go, I see it. What is this? He's blocking my damn way.
Yo, I knew this truce wasn't ever gonna work. I mean, my dad's being so naive. I mean, so naive. These guys are scumbags. Scabs.
Here we go, bro.
Hey, what the f you doing, man? That's my toe you got, man. I need you to drop that.
Right,
yeah, I need you to drop that.
Nah, Blair, this is our lot, bro. I've already got a hook, man.
I don't know how the finance is finding out about our dispatches, but I'm gonna find out.
I see that drop sign right there?
Man, don't worry about the sign, man.
Yeah,
don't
I'm worried about it, man. I'm worried about it.
Before I call my homeboy to come back and beat that ass
tell
again.
Tell everybody
man,
say
go
hi.
Go ahead and drop the call, man.
Have a good one. Hey, I'm taking the car.
I'm all ready to leave, you know? But this guy's in front of my truck.
Man, I need to drop the car, man.
Oh, my God, bro. I knew this truce wasn't going to work between us and the plane.
Drop the car.
But your daddy so got me blocked.
Drop the car.
All of a sudden, here comes the owner. Now I have to give the opportunity to do a drop.
What are you doing? That's my car. I was just tanning for 20 minutes. I had an appointment.
Your car being towed.
What the hell is this?
$115 right now.
Are you serious right now, dude?
We can get a drop right now.
I'm the one that has your car on the hook.
So you guys work together?
We don't work together.
Give me the fee.
What are you
doing,
dude?
You guys
don't have to
do it. Are you really honest right now?
Look, we done been through this already.
We have.
Look. Okay. A tow truck.
It's $115, ma'am. Drop the vehicle here.
What?
If not, I have to take the vehicle. One of the two.
Give me 85.
What are you talking about? 85? Right what 85?
We get it dropped right
hey,
now.
Hey, bro, dude, what are you doing?
Tell you what, let's step away from this clown and let's talk about it.
What do you mean, this clown?
Hey, don't pay
what's
no
going
mind.
On?
But,
huh?
What's going on?
Dude, this guy, he's coming out of nowhere, bro, trying to steal my tow, bro. I got the car on the hook, so.
I called Tremont, so Tremont has to take the car.
Thank you.
Just get out of this car, right? I have a business here.
I just want to get my car back, please. Here, fine, take the money, give me my car back.
I told you.
Hey, yo.
Hey, what are you doing, bro?
Come on, man. You want to get off me, man?
Man?
I told this silly bitch, man.
Bro, hey.
Man, don't put your hands on me.
What are you going to do about it?
You know what I'm going to do about the same thing you caught last time.
You're going to get hurt.
Oh, yeah.
Hey,
yo,
yo,
yo, yo, yo, yo.
Hey, yo. Bitch. What's going on, baby?
Derek, they're towing my car, and he called me a b***h and assaulted me.
I'm going to call you a b***h again, b***h. Touch my lady, man.
Ha-ha! Booyah!
Hey, get off me, man. Get off me.
Yo! Por puta canto de
a
See ya! He was over there getting his ass whooped.
Hey!
Oh, here he comes.
Hey!
If you can.
Hey!
Hey! Tell her I said hi!
Tremont. Yes, I know where the animal hospital is. Yeah, honey, I can tow scooters. It's not a problem. Animal hospital on West Avenue. Got some scooters we need to tow. There's a few of them.
Who are you gonna send?
I kind of don't have anybody to send. They're all kind of busy right now.
Business at Tremont is booming, but the only downside I'm having to it is overextending my drivers in the field.
Just wait a few minutes, and when the first guy gets here, send him over.
No, we're not gonna wait a few minutes. I'll just go do it myself.
I love my dad to death, but he's really stubborn. I mean, he's not in his 20s anymore. I don't like him going out into the field. He can get hurt. You know what kind of weekend it is, you know? The kind of crowd we have here, I really don't think it's a good idea for you to go. Have one of the young guys go.
Oh, have one of the... Have one of the young guys go.
You know I
worry. Are you kidding me?
You know I worry about you.
I'll jump in the flatbed, and I'll go do it myself. It's not a big deal.
It is a big deal.
No, it's not a big deal, huh?
I don't think you should go.
Yeah, I know you don't think I'm gonna go, but I'm gonna go anyway because that's what we do, that's how we make our money. So I will take care of it myself.
Thank you very much for coming. This is an animal hospital, and these scooters are here all the time. I mean, my clients can come in. I have emergencies all the time. I've told them numerous times. I mean, I'm fed up.
If you're old enough to ride a scooter, then you should know better than to park on the sidewalk.
Yo!
Hey, man.
Yo!
What's going on here?
What you doing?
Hey, don't that scooter, man.
What are you doing?
Hey, what are you doing? What are you doing?
Hold on,
hold on. This is bull, man. Look, this is the woman I want to talk to right here. What's going on here?
You told us we could park here.
I never told you
yeah,
to
you
do that.
Yeah, you did.
You are a real stiff bitch, you know that? Just a stiff bitch trying to mess up three teenagers. Beautiful
stuff. Be quiet, bro. We ain't talking to you. Don't touch me.
You're talking to a lady.
Don't touch me. I'll talk to whoever I want. She's
a woman, and you should understand that.
I don't care.
I'm not going to tolerate
you. I'm not afraid of you, bro. You can't do. You can't touch me. What you going to do, bro? Look, right there. What you going to do?
Stop while you're ahead.
Stop what?
Well, stop what? While you're ahead.
You don't understand that?
Wait. Can I help you?
Yeah. Did you put your hands on my son today?
He pushed
me. I put my body up against him, yeah.
I'm gonna sue you for that.
I guess our agreement means nothing, right? It means nothing to them. They beat my son's ass.
They're not gonna stay away because we gotta make a living like everybody else. Don't touch me. Don't touch me. What you gonna do, bro? Look, right there. Right.
Stop while you're ahead.
You don't understand that?
Wait.
I'm gonna call the police. That's it. I am calling the cops just so you know.
Come on. Yo! I'm gonna call the cops now. Your ass is gonna go to jail. Another day at Tremont. I love this. Let me get this.
Well, I'm sorry that you had to go through this.
Don't worry about
it.
Honey, I've been doing this for 25 years on the beach. And that's not the first time some punks decide to put their hands on me. I had this one time picking up those scooters. Got into a little pissing match with some young kids.
How young is young?
I don't know how young they I'll put it this way. It was young enough that when he pushed me, I didn't hit him. Because he was that young. Very disrespectful.
Okay.
Hello?
Can I help you?
Yeah, I would like to talk to the manager, please.
I am the manager.
That's the guy that pushed
me. Oh, really?
That's the guy that pushed me. Yeah, that's the guy.
Did you put your hands on my son today?
Luckily for him, I didn't.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, he pushed me.
I put my body up against him, yeah.
Really?
He pushed me, yeah.
I'm going to sue you for that.
Okay, well, you're going to have to stand in line for that guy.
Crazy?
If a minor puts his hands on me, I can do whatever I have to do to defend myself.
Look at you. He's 100 pounds. You're more like the double of him. How can he hurt you?
The lady told us we could park there, and you just
parked there. The lady never told me we could park there. And that's where your son had a problem.
Why you take the scooter from
him? I don't think your son was quite clear to you what was going on. So why don't you come inside and let me make it a little bit more clearer to you.
Sir, if I actually really put my hands on your son, you wouldn't be visiting me here.
You did push me.
He can say all he wants to say.
He's lying.
He can keep on saying I'm lying.
So you're
lying.
You're calling my dad a liar?
He's a liar.
My dad is lying. He's got no reason to lie.
Look at me. Look at him. I can have his butt in jail because his friend stole the bike that I already had in possession of.
Which guys you were with?
Anthony and Casper.
Anthony, I told you don't hang out with those guys.
Oh, I see you weren't quite clear in everything, were you?
You're lying. She
I have videotape of everything. We'll show the videotape.
He's lying. That's what
video
I know.
Video never
lying.
Lies.
He's lying.
You'll see everything.
Something. Do you want me to look at those videotapes? I can look at them.
Come on, let's say your father and I
take
will
the
go
time.
Look at the videotapes.
So tell me, do you want me to look at them? Is it worth it?
No. No.
You know, guy, you're disrespecting your father by acting this way.
All right, how much is it going to cost me to get that scooter back?
It's $150.
$150, cash.
All right. I'll take
him to scooter. I got it. All right, sir. You can
take I appreciate it, guys.
I apologize.
I know it's not easy.
To the gentleman.
I'm sorry.
All right. Sorry. You're lucky with me. It might not get lucky the next time you do that. It might not be me.
I don't want to hear you.
The kid seems to be a really good kid.
Yeah, I mean, he's 16 at that age. I'm having so many problems.
They're very impressionable at that age.
If I see you back on my beach with your scooter, you, your little friends, there's gonna be a problem. Someone open the gate. Remember what I told you. I'm not kidding around.
That wasn't me, I swear.
That wasn't me. Come on, you're so
guilty.
That's your
ringtone. Me, Chrissy, in the office, chilling, rapping, talking trash like always, talking smack.
Oh, man, I caught you red-handed.
I don't play like that.
Hey, what's going on?
Not so much. I am with Animal Rescue Services.
Got a man, you married?
I'm talking about the dog, sir.
You can make it a triple date if you want to.
I'm talking about the dog. I have to do some last-minute reporting, get some signatures.
All right, come on, honey. I'll let you in right now.
All right.
The animal lady came back to do an update on Muffin.
Just need to get some last signatures.
I think she was really there to see J Money. What's up, baby?
What's going on?
How you doing?
I'm good. What you been up to?
Like your nails.
Thank you.
They ain't press-ons or nothing like that?
No.
Huh?
We don't do press-ons.
Looking all sexy.
Ah! Tell him to stop.
Nice hairdo.
Oh my God, you're making me blush. I'm here on business.
I'm on business too.
And what's your business?
Your business.
Oh.
So what's up? You going out or what?
Where are we going?
Somewhere special.
Like?
I don't know yet. I'm gonna take you somewhere good, all right?
You gonna come get me?
Yeah, I'm coming to get you. We get a limousine.
Oh.
We can ride in my personal car.
Well, you giving me options.
We can jump in a tow truck.
No. Pause right there. No tow truck. That's where you put your other girls.
What?
You ride them in the tow truck.
I can't even answer that question.
Why?
How that person?
You silly.
So what's up?
All right. I'm gonna give you a try. We'll go out. You got my number, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'll pick up.
You sure?
I just said I will. I promise.
I ain't gonna forget that pretty smile.
So let me get out of here. All right, y'all. Bye.
Honey, thanks for coming and visiting.
All righty.
Hey,
Why do we have this?
Funny story. Technically, I have every right to take this tow truck. If it's blocking spaces, it's in my lot, it's totally legit.
Does Larry even know we have this yet?
I'm pretty sure he's making a phone call now. I told him to say hi to Larry for me.
I have a truce with Larry, but his drivers are doing what they're not supposed to be doing again. Robbie handled a very difficult situation very well.
Put it over to a hold. You make life complicated. Those guys at Finest can't be trusted. The truce is off.
Oh my God, just doing something for me.
I'm doing something for you? That's kind of gross.
You're looking all right, all your tattoos.
What do you want? I got a question for you. You maybe want to get one over on Larry?
She made it to the top of the scale, so she must be fine.
How long are you gonna keep this one around for?
I don't know. Come on. I'm a smooth talker, baby.
He has too many on the hook as it is, you know, so let's get real.
Okay. Hello.
Where's your dad? Oh, Lord, I can already see who that face is. Wait a minute. Oh. This is my aftermarket from Robbie, right?
Mm-hmm. Your son.
Robert, where's my truck?
Obviously in my lot, bud.
I can see that. Why is it in here, Robert?
Well, it's real simple, guy. First of all, you guys were stealing cars again from my property, and then they left the truck in my property, so it got
towed. How does it make it your property, Robert?
My signs were up there.
The lot says Tremont Towing. His truck was blocking another car in the middle of my lot. If you park illegally, you're gonna get towed.
Your drivers are doing exactly what we agreed not to do. Onto the properties, they're trying to take cars off our properties where they're supposed to be staying on the other side of the bridge.
Give me my truck.
You got $250?
What?
$250.
For my truck.
For your truck.
All right, it's a small world, remember that.
Yeah, I know, it goes round and round and round and eventually ends up in the same place.
Usually does.
Yeah. Keep your man under control. We might not have to do this,
but
we'll see
what
going
happens.
And going. All right. Hold on 1 second. Keep your dogs outside. You can come in.
They're not my dogs. They're my driver, Robert.
Then they should act like them.
We'll see.
Come on in, Larry.
Okay, it's like that. So all this agreement, all these things we got going on means nothing, right?
It means a lot, but apparently don't mean nothing to these guys you got working for you. All this would be prevented if they just stay on the other side of the bridge where they're supposed to stay.
Why that side of the bridge?
This is a beach. Miami.
And
that's Cambodia. This
beach,
is Miami Beach.
The beach don't belong to you guys. It belongs to everybody.
Oh, my God. You looking good back there.
Excuse me?
You're just doing something for me. You turning
I'm
me on.
I'm doing something for you?
Yeah.
I'm turning you on.
Yeah.
That's kind of gross.
You're looking all right. All your tattoos.
Excuse
me? Let me see them sexy ass toes you got down there.
Hold on, homeboy. What's up?
Oh, boy,
What's good? You don't need to talk to her, man. You talk to me, homeboy.
Man, we dealt with y'all last time.
Yeah, you was on your ass last time.
Man, whatever.
You remember that? You remember this face?
The bottom line is he was not supposed to be there, and that's why we got the truck.
Doing all that doesn't mean that anything is going to get fixed. All is going to create more problems and more problems between us. You think this is fair?
Hey, sweetheart. I love some ink, boy, and I love that. Come on over here.
What the kill, boy?
Jerome, tell him I just threw up in my mouth a little. Never in a million years would I touch his disgusting ass.
What?
You heard that?
What she said?
Disgusting, man.
She want to suck what?
Excuse me?
Well, don't let me come out this gate,
Make
boy.
It out this door, then.
Keep on going, babe.
I guess our agreement means nothing, right?
It means nothing to them. It's supposed to mean something to you and me.
They're not coming, stay away, Robert.
They're not gonna stay away because we gotta make a living like everybody else.
Get out the window, go call that little thick thing back. Let me handle what you can.
Y'all get happy when you see a female, you ain't never had none before. But you like you been in prison, my I'm saying, get all pumped up, huh?
All right, I see how it is. All that agreement we said, everything that happened with your son, it meant nothing.
Excuse me. They beat my son's ass.
You saw the way they were behaving. You saw the behavior.
I didn't let that go.
Remember, the bridge is a two-way street. It goes one way, and it comes the other way.
Yeah. I just love this, baby.
Come on, let's go, guys. Here, get the car and bring it over.
All right, I'll see you when we get there.
All right.
Are you kidding me right now? That just happened?
That boy out the chain.
That just happened.
That mean he don't get none at home.
We finally get Larry out of the yard. His driver hops in the truck with him. Next thing I know. What is she still doing here?
Come on out here. Come on.
What do you want?
Oh, man. I'm trying to figure out if y'all hiring or not, man. They done cut my commission over there. They acting like a bitch over there. I'm trying to see if y'all hiring. What's up?
We're hiring.
Y'all hiring?
Mm-hmm.
All right, let me give you my number real quick. Damn. Y'all ain't got no women tow drivers over here?
I'm the only woman here, honey.
Oh, man. Y'all give me a call, man.
Tell them
I'm ready. I need that money.
All right.
Christy, definitely time to go home. 19 hours, I'm done.
I got a question for you.
What's that?
You maybe want to get one over on Larry?
Okay.
How do you like them apples?
Oh, well, it's different.
Not so sour, eh? Pretty sweet.
Hello, Bernice.